Lars is curator of Helsingland Museum and of course one of the main executors and co-curators of this exhibition. And Lars' research focuses on medieval art and especially the sacral heritage of northern Swedish churches, the Norrland, but also on the painting tradition in Helsingland from the 17th and 18th century. And he's also a doctoral researcher, and you are going to defend soon. And this is also the topic of his dissertation. Lars has published a lot, and also he's the one who has written a book about the Bollnäs Church, and also have researched the wonderful sculpture and altarpiece collection of Bollnäs. And I may say that Lars is one of the best researchers who is working with the northern Swedish medieval art. So I'm really happy that you are going to talk today. And Lars' topic is late medieval altarpieces and sculptures in Helsingland churches. Objecthood, production and consumption. Please, Lars.
Thank you. Good morning, dear friends. When the holy kinship altarpiece left the port of Tallinn, the destination of the altarpiece was not a cathedral, nor a town's church. It was Bollnäs church in the countryside of the province of Hälsingland. What other altarpieces from the same time were and still are in Hälsingland? Where were they ordered from? And how have they survived to us today? The province of Hälsingland is in the north of Sweden. There were no towns in Hälsingland in the medieval time. The oldest city is Hudiksvall, chartered in 1582. The northernmost town in Sweden was Gävle, located in the most southern part of Norrland, just south of Hälsingland in the province of Gästrikland. Hälsingland and the whole of Norrland had no nobility. The farmers or peasants of Sweden have always been free, and in Hälsingland they played a leading role in society. Almost all of the land was owned by the farmers themselves. Just a little was owned by the church to provide for the vicars. According to the records from the 16th century, some of the farmers were also merchants and craftsmen. The role of a burgess was spread out over a large rural area. The countryside merchants also engaged in overseas trade. There is a wealth of information on local craftsmen, mostly coppersmiths, but also some carpenters and painters. We don't have any records from the medieval times about this, but most likely the conditions were the same in the 15th century. This is a map over Hälsingland, and it had 32 medieval parishes with stone churches. There were two provosts, one in Bollnäs and one in Forsa. It was divided in two deaneries, as you see, Alir or Bollnäs and Sundhed. Hälsingland was a part of the Archdiocese of Uppsala and still is. Bollnäs was one of the most wealthy parishes in the whole north of Sweden. The churches of Hälsingland were mostly built in the 12th and 13th centuries and were expanded to large hall churches during the Middle Ages. This example is the church of Njutånger, which was a 1100s Romanesque church with lower choir, which was replaced with an extension in the 1400s, leaving a very long and narrow church. In early 1500s, as estimated from preserved works of art, the average parish church had at least 10 sculptures, one altarpiece, one triumphal crucifix, one processional crucifix, and 7 single sculptures of saints. The large and more important churches had many more. Nine churches had towers. Bollnäs is one of them. The tower have, as you see, Baltic brick ornaments, and the church has some extensions from the 18th century today. Of all of the churches in Hälsingland, Bollnäs has the largest number of preserved medieval works of art. Altogether, there are 27 sculptural objects, 2 large altarpieces, 3 triumphal crucifixes, 3 small crucifixes, and 18 sculptures with or without shrines, and 1 fragment. The earliest of them is from the 13th century, 3 are from the 14th century, and 23 from the period 1450 to 1530. Inventories reveal even more now missing sculptures, for example, a Saint George group, George the Dragon, the princess and her parents. This is the interior of Bollnäs church today. You can recognize the Holy Kinship altarpiece above the pulpit. Most of the preserved medieval altarpieces and sculptures in Hälsingland are from the late Middle Ages, from the end of the 15th century and the beginning of the 16th century. We have not many records, but according to a preserved accounting book from Stöde in Medelpad, just north of Hälsingland, dating from 1504 to 1534, walls, textiles and sculptures were purchased with parish money. This was probably the general way in which church art was commissioned. Here we see a sculpture of Saint Anne, and according to the account book, the price was 26 marks. The year was 1528, and this is a work from Håkan Gullesson's workshop, but the noses are from a 20th century restoration. The pilgrimage route to Trondheim and Saint Olaf brought pilgrims to the church. Some churches with good indulgence privileges probably could use some of the income generated on church art. One of those churches was in Bollnäs. 7 cardinals gave 100 days of indulgence. In this letter, dated in Rome in 1465. There is also another letter from 1468 for Bollnäs church, but that's only 40 days from the archbishop. Bollnäs was and still are a very large parish, 900 square kilometers. In the mid-1500s, the tax register count more than 200 farms in the parish. And they paid tithe to the church, one-tenth on their harvest and animals, until 1527, when the king, Gustav Vasa, you know, took away this income from the church. So until 1527, the Swedish church had good economy. The Archbishop of Uppsala made visits to Hälsingland during the winter every third or fourth year. The Archbishop visits provided opportunities for discussion on how to commission altarpieces, what to order and from where. The Archbishop in 1470 to 1515 for 45 years was named Jakob Ulfsson Örnfot. He probably had a large number of contacts through which he could commission church art. His crest, the eagle foot, as you see here, on a mural with the archbishop himself, looking very young. He must have been at least 100 years old in that time. And from an altarpiece, the eagle foot. It can be seen in a lot of churches, both in murals and altarpieces. He lived in the same time as Kurt Rogge, which Carina talked about yesterday. They both loved church art and were great donors to the church. Altarpieces and sculptures were sent to churches in Norrland from towns in the area around Lake Mälaren and from abroad. One example is the altarpiece on the main altar today in Bollnäs church, made by Jordan Målare, who lived in Arboga and Stockholm in the late 15th century. This is probably about 1470 or 1480s. And he used models from Meister E.S. from the south of Germany, very near the prints of Meister E.S. You probably recognize that. Some of the churches commissioned altarpieces and other artworks from large art centers abroad. As the best example today, of course, the Bollnäs Holy Kinship altarpiece from the east. We have some others. This is the altarpiece of Enånger, which is from Lübeck. Henning von der Heide, yeah. With the Madonna and two apostles. And this is some remade main altarpiece in Ljusdal with the Passion. And it's from Antwerp. And if we go north, we can find in the old provost churches of Norrland, going further north, we can find this Brussels altarpiece in Nordingrå. Also the Passion, as you see. And oops, we go to Skellefteå with a Lübeck altarpiece. Bernt Notke, yes, with the Holy Trinity in the middle, and Saint Olaf, and we go to the further north, almost as long north you come. This is Nedre Luleå, also an Antwerp altarpiece with the Passion, with remade wings. But we go to the local masters, the lack of towns with guild craftsmen and workshops, and the great demand for altarpieces and sculptures in the north of Sweden were probably the reason some local workshops were set up in the late Middle Ages. The most famous of them was led by Håkan Gulleson, one of the craftsmen working on the countryside in Hälsingland. This hand sculpture is signed and dated. Here is the signature. He says, "I, Håkan Gulleson, maler." And he dated on the side, 1520. His signature is still preserved on 6 sculptures, 4 in Hälsingland, 1 in Medelpad, and 1 in Jämtland. In one of his signatures, he writes Håkan Gulleson in Flekum. And Flekum, Flecka, is a village in Enånger. And here we find Håkon in the oldest surviving text register, tax register, from 1535. And in 1542, it's Olof Håkansson, probably his son. So Håkan Gulleson, his working time is probably 1490 to 1530. He worked in a modern style with some older materials, and his works exhibit special attributes. The most obvious characteristics of his depicted characters are very sleepy eyes, hanging eyelids, very red cheeks, nose very red too, and up in the forehead. The late art historian Lennart Karlsson interpreted the signature Mahler as he was the painter in this workshop and the leader of the workshop, and he had at least one very good wood carver. This is St. Olaf in Borgsjö in Medelpad. It's also signed Haken. And that one very good wood carver also made this one. And he enjoyed to make very symmetric curly beards, very often seen on the male sculptures. This is the small Madonna of Bollnäs church. There is also a big Madonna. It's not signed and dated, but we clearly see it's the same workshop was made this, no doubts. Anonymous workshops with craftsmen working in a style similar to Håkan Gulleson were, according to the dissemination of their works, located at least in Jämtland and in Ångermanland, and they were operating in the same time as Håkan Gulleson's workshop, 1500 to 1530. And some of the altarpieces of Håkan Gulleson. And in the middle you see a Holy Kingship altarpiece of Söderala. And it's said that the Bollnäs Holy Kingship could have been a model for this, but I'm not so sure. The three parts is the only thing similar, I think. And the sculptures of Hälsingland is often very, they are very, very often well preserved according to the climate. It's not so wet and not so dry. The churches has been very good environment for the sculptures. Except for the provinces of Jämtland and Härjedalen. The north of Sweden has always been a part of Sweden. The absence of war in the area created good conditions for the preservation of large number of medieval art objects. A major threat was the change in fashion in the 18th and 19th century, in which medieval altarpieces of high altars were replaced. In particular, small wooden sculptures of saints, tabernacle shrines, without their shrines often have been preserved from the churches of Norrland. In 1859, the Hälsingland Society of Antiques was founded. Its main purpose was to save medieval art. The founder, the provost Lars Landgren, saw on his visits to parishes that the medieval churches and art were in bad condition and had an uncertain future. The old church of Enånger, with murals from the 15th century, was saved from destruction and it became a sanctuary for unwanted church art. Over 200 objects, mostly medieval altarpieces and wooden sculptures, but also limestone, baptism fonts, textiles and censers, were moved to Enånger's old church in 1861 to 1863, including objects from Bollnäs. This is the interior from early 1900s, and it's more a storage than an exhibit. In the early 1900s, an academic and popular interest in medieval church art created an awareness of the value of this cultural heritage. Exhibits of medieval church art were held in Östersund 1911, Härnösand in 1912, Hudiksvall in 1913. After that, the medieval sculptures were again put on display in the churches, and beginning in the 1920s, objects from Enånger collection were given back to the churches of origin to Bollnäs in 1928. The Hälsingland Society of Antiques is the same organization as today Hälsingland Museum. The methods of photography were used early in the museum work. And here is a picture, no, here are three pictures from 1877, the oldest pictures of the Holy Kingship altarpiece taken in Enånger Old Church. In 1928, the sculptures of Bollnäs, some of them were taken back, and Oscar Svensson restored the altarpieces. And the Holy Kingship altarpiece was in good condition, except for the outsides of the doors. So the changes was not very much. So this is the corpus before restoration. And you see, four sculptures are missing. Saint Anne, the Christ child, and two of the children of Mary Cleophas. And today, Saint Anne is replaced with a modern copy of 1928, but that's a story of its own, and I will not take that now. The wings were, as you see, also in very good condition, but the outside of the doors was not so good. But if you compare the today's look and this photograph, you can see that Oscar Svensson made a good work because he did not put a new face on Saint Eric. He just made small lines to fill out the lacunes. And for example, you can see the face of Saint Olaf on the right. It's very well preserved. This is the naked Bollnäs church. In 1794, all the medieval wooden sculptures and altarpieces were moved to a storage room. The fashion was not to have the medieval sculptures. The Swedish Reformation bishops were not so were not against Catholic art, but the fashion in the 18th century was probably very nice Rococo furnishing was replaced with this neoclassical interior in 1878. We have no pictures of the interior before 1878. But in 1928, the two big altarpieces and some crucifixes and sculptures were given back from the museum. And this was the look of Bollnäs church when I was small, in the 80s still. And in the 90s, in 1903, there was a renovation again. And today, this is the interior of Bollnäs church. And the cultural heritage of the medieval art is in use every Sunday and other church day in Bollnäs church. And it can be visited every day, so people can meet the medieval heritage. So that was the end.